Well, as lawmakers in Madison prepare to vote on the governor's budget this month, protesters have set up shop nearby. 12 News' Brendan Conway just back from Madison tonight, and he joins us with a look at why protest organizers are thinking beyond this fight.
And Jason, this was the scene in Madison just a few months ago when large groups of protesters converged on the Capitol. So far, the crowds this time around, they are smaller and calmer. But like those protesters in the winter, they say they're not going away.
With their drums and signs, the protesters who left the state capitol 3 months ago in the wake of the battle over collective bargaining rights are back. Only this time, they're outside. Dozens of tents line the streets in the shadow of the Capitol for what organizers are calling Walkerville.
We came out here today just to keep up the support and the solidarity.
John Rademacher and his wife, who are both Madison teachers, doubt this protest will stop the budget from passing, but they think it could have long-term impacts.
Even if it's not three senators that change their mind right away, next elections, next time they are up, you know, this is something that'll linger in their mind.
Organizers share that message. They say this campout is as much about gathering support for recalls as anything else.
I don't think the Republicans in the legislature are going to change, but I think the people of Wisconsin are going to make that change.
Republicans say that while very public events like this might get a lot of the attention, they argue that most people in Wisconsin support what the governor's doing.
Real leadership is not doing the easy thing, and it's not passing a buck. Real leadership is doing the hard thing, and that's exactly what this budget does. That's exactly what the budget repair bill does.
24 hours into the protest, the weather has been warm and dry. The protesters say even if it gets bad, they're not going anywhere.
We're not giving up the fight. We're not slinking away. We will be here until we resolve this.
Protesters are not allowed to camp on Capitol grounds, but they do have permits that allow them to stay in tents across the street until June 20th. Organizers say, Jason, about 150 people slept outside last night. They expect it to grow in the coming weeks as the school lets out, and a large protest, we're told, is being planned for next Saturday.
All right, the crowds return. Thank you, Brendan.